Welcome back to the Go Champions League Season 4 quarterfinal between Ironix and Pride. Well, who will take home the prize of the semi-final? And at least $500, we will find out on this map. It's Train. As you can see, the ninth round just headed into the final stage. Pride will have the CT side, probably. There we go. So, I went to the kitchen to get a spoon twice and forgot it twice. Don't ask what I did, I don't know either. It's just too hot tonight. Thank you for tuning in. We will find out who is going to head into the semi-final. The first semi-finalist. We have another best of three coming up tonight between MM Club and... and XPC. And it seems like... visitors. Thank you. Yes, that's the guy. Thank you. Yeah, so the German viewers already know that I've got German colleagues, obviously. So they're really cool, though. Really cool. Just brought me some beverages from below. They having some party. Now, Ironix having a party as well on the A-bomb set, but it gets crashed by Sud and Exus, so the 4v3 in favor of the CTs. It looked promising for Ironix at the start, but it doesn't look too promising anymore. Now Otto is coming back to the ground and the smoke has faded, so the terrorists have open line of vision, or sight, rather. Morel's in a 1v3. Oh, he's getting cheeky as well, picking off the first one, but Otto is in the pop dog area. Morel's now crammed in between. He gets another one, but Otto with a triple kill. Oh, 1-0 in favor of Ironix. And it seems like I have to change the overlay again since the teams decided to switch around again. But a nice first round by both teams, actually. Not giving up, showing their resilience again. They did that throughout the first two maps already. Now we've got Pride on one side, Pride on the other side. That will be fixed in a second. Yeah, there we go. It's always a hassle, you know, if the teams knife and they switch sides and then they start the pissed round already. You don't have time to type their names in there and stuff like that. So usually in all the lands, you know, $100,000 productions, they have people doing that for the casters, but it's not possible for a smaller tournament. Now we've got the CTs on the force by Ironix. Taking down the first two of them. Two Deagles and a 5-7. We could see some damage dealt by Morels. And probably Morels has been so strong. Exus is still alive as well. Not anymore. As I say his name, he's going down. David Tate with the UMP. Skrunk getting one as well. And Ironix on the 2-0. Reaper will just try and save his 5-7 and the armor. It would help him in the next round. Will hold on to that gun as well. Ah, I've got cool water here. Bavarian water. So the CTs, yeah, they are saving. Ironix will probably not have any trouble winning this one. Well, if you look around and you see somebody standing right next to you with a USP, you're either screaming your lungs out on your teammates because they must have messed up, or you're screaming your lungs out because you're scared to death. He was scared to death, but the bomb will be planted eventually. Exodus ends soon. I'm trying to inflict as many damage as possible to the terrorists. Three men, Otto and David K, will try to prevent that from happening. David K with the first UMP kill. Nice job by him. 1v3, and he's not gonna get any more. David K is there, collecting money and frags at the same time. 3-0 in favor of Aeronix. Now we see the first rifle round, and that's really the first, or the second real round, the second important one. And we've got some Pride fans showing their colors in the chat. Welcome to the stream, guys and girls. And obviously, a late shout out to Joseph for reminding me in case I would have forgotten it, which regularly happens, so thanks, Joseph. Minis with the first one in Pop Dog. He's pushing back through the smoke into safety. The terrorists line up on the B bomb set. Nobody at Ivy, nobody at A main. So, if the CTs knew, if they had some aggression over there, they would know, and they would be able to rotate. But Repo is left alone over there. His teammates are coming in, thanks to the grenades that have been tossed into this bomb site. Pride has no real equipment anymore. Morales with one smoke, a flash for Repo. Morales getting the kill onto David K, a 3v5, now fails on 6 HP. He can't put any more resistance up. Freeman with the UMP, not the perfect weapon to have. And he goes down to Repo. Skrunk is disposed of by Exodus. Pride are on the board, and they only lose one guy in the process of winning it. Well, that gives them more money to work with. On, at the same time, the terrorists have farmed a lot of money. David K and Otto got so many UMP, not USP frags. Isn't it the same manufacturer? I think it's both Heckler. Is it Heckler? I'm not sure. The UMP is Heckler, that's sure. But USP, I don't know who produces that. Now let's see what the second rifle round brings us. Terrorists would be able to get another one here. With 5,000 on David K, 2,000 on, almost 2,000 on two players. If they get the bomb plant, they might be able to put out another force. Now Skrunk and Zoom trading blows on different parts of the map. Skrunk at A main, and the terrorists lose their first man too soon at Ivy. Now some information gathered by Exus, a very dangerous attempt to get that information, but Skrunk is so low that Exus figured I can try it. Ah yeah, nice. I like when the chat communicates. Thanks guys. I knew that I know everything about weapons. I just wasn't sure. So, Skrunk, what is he supposed to do? He can try and fake the A bomb site. He can maybe try to draw some attention away, but the terrorists will go for A anyway. They're running through Pop Dog, having lined up those three players. They have to watch out. Repo is on the back stab, and Phaser goes down to the flames of Morales. Exodus going down, but Morales holds the line with two kills. Three men on the headshot, making it a 2v2 again. Repo drops right there. I used the analogy already, but it looked like a meteorite. Skrunk on 11 HP with 5 seconds. He just gets the bomb planted. That was so important. That was probably more important than anything else he did in this round. Morales. Oh, what? Morales is getting it. Nice kill by him. Oh, but now he's angry. Look at him. Looking at his knife, looking at his teammate in the eye, saying, "You just stole those points away from me. You better regret that or I slit you." Sister, I love that. Minis is half man, half stand-in. Seven-Eleven is a part-time, or was a part-time job. I love you guys, man. So Pride on two orbs now. Natera is trying to break through the CT's lines. He was there with a max 7. He's pushing it back. Get two kills for him already. Nobody there in the B hallways anymore. The terrorist coming around into A again. Skrung is there trying to catch Minis off or cut him off. And he did both. He caught him off guard and he cut him off as well. There's some more damage by Skrung, but no kills for him. Soon stays alive with 23 and fails up against 4 CTs. He's coming in from Pop Dog. Ooh, misses that shot onto Morales. It was a mile sticking out of the CT, but fails. Well, he lived up to his name in this moment. Good performance throughout the previous two maps, though, so really just a small joke on his behalf. CTs have Reaper waiting inside B, just like always. Now he's. he called in for the rotation. His teammates came around, and when he checked that corner, you can tell that he was stopping for a millisecond, and that's the moment when he realized, wait, he was supposed to be around here. And then FaZe fires that shot from that area, and Reaper already knows, okay, he was a tiny bit too fast. 3v3. 3-2-3. The terrorists, in desperate times, they go for T250s. Soon is killing them one after another. He's got a shooting gallery in the middle of the map. Scrunch running through and down the lines, but Exus only loses 20 HP. Not a problem at all. 4-3 in favor of Pride. P90 on these. They should have enough money, they do. So, it was a deliberate choice of weapon. Ooh, yes. The P90 just sounds awful as well. Already sprung. Getting back for the terrorist, but a quick trade results in a 2v2. Repo turns it into a 2v1. Sprung is left alone. And now let me see your support in the chat. Can he pull this off? The bomb is dropped in the middle. He's up against an orb. Soon just looked away and then tracks him down again as Skrunk opens fire. Pride will win another round, a 5-3, but this time around it got close. Many decisive round wins by Pride give them a lot of money to work with on three players. Exus and Minis having a little worse time there, but apart from that, everything is okay. What? I hate when casters just say what, but that was one of those moments. A 29 bullet spray of the Galil, and he gets the kill against Repo. Repo should be a little bit ashamed. The Galil is really not the strongest spraying weapon. Kinda have to spray, but rather burst spray, kind of. It's a weird gun. But the spray pattern is probably something that the least amount of pros have nailed down in practice. They probably practice the UMP more than they practice the Galil. Now, Aronix stack up one more frag to make it a 5v3. A German caster calls it the Galol because of the spray. More like, lol, you gotta kill, you know. And, oh, Morales was about to turn around. Oh, such a bad timing for him, but look at the damage he dealt. Soon with a kill onto one of the two full HP team members of the terrorist. Otto is one of them. Skrunk getting the kill onto Exus fails. It goes down too soon. And now, do the CTs know they dealt as much damage as they did? Or is it Soon just casually hanging around, trying to get some kills, or is it actually trying to get it? The bomb is ticking faster and faster, so he's probably not going to try it, but he could get an exit frag. That wouldn't be that bad. but misses that shot onto, I think it was Otto. Yeah, must have been Otto. But he stays alive, and that is maybe just as important as getting the kill. Probably more important, especially with his AWP. So double AWP in play for Pride again. After saving the one, they purchased another one, and Exus is carrying it too. Great success. And Terrorists left with four players. Now that makes their execution a little harder. They have all the players around the A bomb site. But they're going for B now. So they keep both openings. They went for that pop dog execution already with one player from A main. But it looks like they want to go for a different approach this time around. Repo and Exus are holding the B-bomb set together. I wonder why Repo accepts somebody else to be on his side with him. But it's a good idea by Pride, that's for sure. Oh, double Molotov on Repo. He's never gonna go for that peak, but he goes for that peak. Gets the kill, but the bomb got planted. Somehow the terrorists managed to get it down. Fail zone, 34 HP, but gets the first one. Jumps down. Yes, what is the shed? Oh, the second. But then it's done and dusted. Exus defuses the bomb. Triple kill for him. And the covering kill by Minis. Pride with a 6-4 now. Repo holding B alone again after he deemed Exus expendable after his triple kill. Nah, come on, you just killed all my kills. Maybe that is Exus so because he might play a little more selfish in those situations when he's standing in. But you never know. I didn't analyze it. Just throwed it out. Because a lot of players do that. I'm not saying he does, but I'm saying maybe it could be. Or else, and Minis get traded back and forth. Phaser with the advantage for the terrorist. The bomb goes down. Aronix finally got the bomb planned again. But now they have to get into good positions. Otto just pushes through to Z connector. With a Tech-9 in hand, and unlike the event to happen, but he gets it done. And Exus goes down as well. It's soon alone. And he needs to save it or win the round. You heard those letters. My dad, grandma would have heard them. David K still in a 1v2. But the bomb is going to blow up soon. Just did as much damage as possible. He kept them around. He kept them in there, so he eliminated the terrorists, which makes them suffer some economical blow. And you can see they don't have as much money as they would like to have. Pride with a chance to win this round and then win the next one as well, because the terrorists would be on a save. And look at the mixed buy by Pride, as well as the terrorists. We have a UMP for David K. We have a 5-7 for Repo, who is supported by Minis on B. And Repo with a 5-7 going for the information close by. He wants to bait the terrorists in, so could... Oh no, he's not baiting anymore. Minis left him alone there, and that was the most unfortunate timing ever for an AWP player to go for the rotation. 4v4, Minis with the kill for the CTs. Now he's calling in for the rotation of his teammates. He gets another one before going down to Phaser. Another trade results in a 2v2. The CTs have soon on the site already. Morels has to move in through the connector while Phaser and three men are working together.
phases on the site. Three men is in the hallways. He's covering the backside. Now Soon exposes his position already. Three men make some noise. The CTs know where he is. He gives away his position again. They fake the defuse. He just checks it, shoots it first in the face, and Soon retaliates. The bomb will be defused by Pride to make it a 7-5. And Ironix make the CT struggle financially. They have 5 rounds on the board, which is okay on train. But they have chances, so many opportunities. Turned the wrong corner, but again he gets a kill and tags another one. Morales with a famas mops up those frags. Freeman with an assist on his teammate. And Skrunk, the only one to get another kill for the terrorist. What a quick round by the CTs. Soon has, really, if there was some kind of roleplay involved in CSGO, please, Valve, don't listen. We would have an orb with kills plus 1.5. That's Soon's orb. He always gets 1.5 kills. Repo alone on B, faced off against the majority of the terrorists coming his way. The teammate will split them apart, or so it seems. He gets 2 kills. Otto pushes through, but he's got 22 HP. It's not really that much, and he goes down to the nade of Soon. Oh, Skrunk taken out as well. Soon is getting more and more momentum. Three man in a 1v4. And Ironix with all their hopes resting on his shoulders. They don't know where he is, but what way? You can see the defuser. Why did he shot? Oh no! Come on! The corpse was leaned against this corner here. And from this angle, from his perspective, the smoke didn't cover this. But the head popped out there, so he thought there was a CT cowering on the bomb, defusing it. And he shot the head of the corpse. How unfortunate. And, you know, it wouldn't have happened in 1.6. Just saying. Morales pushing catches Skrunk off guard. Gets traded by Phaser, so the terrorists can work with that. That's definitely something they could use. Kind of a free frag. A 1-for-1 trade definitely suits the terrorists. Doesn't favor them, but it's better for them than it is for the CTs. And we're in the last round of this half, so saving is not an option anymore. Minis and Soon make it look like they don't need to save any way. Phase of three men. Still want to do something here. Soon has that one line covered. Phaser has no option. Oh, he just slipped through his fingers. Exos climbs up the train, drops the bomb carrier, and gets another one. 10-5 in favor of Pride. Another team effort by Ironix. A little gap here between three men and David K. But the terrorists, well, they were CTs. But man, Pride did a very, very good job. 18-15. They never let loose of their economy, and that's the important part. If Pride can break the CT's economy once, they almost won the game already. There is trying to make their moves obvious. Exos is holding the bomb at the trash bin at the spawn alley. David K getting one on Soon. The CT's on the full rotation. Now the terrorists make their way back through the hallways into Pop Dog at the A bomb site, and the bomb gets carried in through Ivy. Skrunk with one mini is there. He's already on the bomb train. Exos picks up two, and it's Otto and David K. They get it back to a 2v2. 15 HP remain for Repo. Doesn't keep him from anything. He's so reckless. He's so self-confident. It's a pleasure to watch him right now. Otto in a 1v2. Maybe he can pull it back. He just needs to find those two players. He knows Repo was around the C connector, so he wouldn't be a threat if Otto went for the defuse. Now he's got the kit as well. He might just go for it. He sticks to the bomb. Oh, he's aborting it. Exus showed himself. And now he has to bait them in again. But now they play the time and now they win the round. Exus with the triple. Nice try by Otto. But that was those decisions you have to make in those situations when you start defusing your bomb. The first 3 seconds you don't hear anything. And then in the second, you know, in the one of the two last seconds, you hear a footstep. And obviously your brain gets triggered. You look up, you abort the defuse, and then you realize, damn it! He just stepped, he didn't see. And you know, that's always heartbreaking to me. Now Pride is making light work of Oironix, 12-5. They have a 7-round difference between each other. That gives Pride a lot of time to work with. If they should start losing rounds, let's say they lose 5 rounds in a row. It's still 12-10. They are still 2 rounds in the lead. They can go for save rounds, they can go for force buys, they can do whatever they like. 5 rounds in a row doesn't matter to them. Now East Oironix unable to pull it back. David Kane fails to make it look like it. 4v3. Morales with the MP7. An unlikely choice of weapon. Tier 1 teams usually don't buy the MP7. Got a better return on investment. And, well, in the end, Morales picks up 3 kills with the MP7. Proves me wrong. 13-5. The CT's on the first spy. Phaser doesn't have any nades. It might be a problem for him if he gets into a position like Ivy, where he has to flash himself back into safety, get back around the corner, something like that. Ooh, but he gets a free frag onto Soon. Oh, misses that easy one. That was easier than the first one. Minis stays alive at Ivy. But Skrunk picks off Morales and Repo. Sneaks through the door from Pop Dog into the courtyard. He hasn't seen the CT right next to him. That's Otto pushing to the back. 3 men, doesn't let that happen in the... And Oironix make it 6 rounds for themselves. And a mixed buy by Pride. After losing 1 round, they are already on the Tech-9 and the Deagle for Minis and Repo. Seems like they want to take it to 8, but it's never sure what's right. The rotation area from Ivy, I mean, it takes a time to get to B, but it's still possible, especially with 1:13 on the clock. And when he's probes the A bomb site, he doesn't get the kill onto Otto, tags him once. That makes his teammate's job a little easier. Maybe Repo can capitalize on the damage his teammate already did. While Phaser spots somebody on B, he gives up his position already. Repo was the other probe on B. Now the CTs go for the rotation. Phaser's not too sure if the terrorist might not end up on his bomb site. But Pride is nowhere near now. 37 seconds. It's gonna be the A, that's for sure. 3 men distracted a little bit. Otto going down to Morales. Morales with a second. Exus doesn't have anyone to shoot anymore. Now let's see what Skrunk can do from within the bomb site. Gets 2 kills. Nice job by him. Maintains the man advantage. And Repo only gets 1 back. Oironix win the 2nd round in a row. They give themselves a break. So Oronyx pulling it back, the terrorists forcing it up with 3 Tech 9s and an AK for Morels, a P250 on Minis. And Repo is taking the point again. He's so confident. It's awesome. Phaser. Oh no, it's not Phaser, it's David K. Grunk is there supporting him from Super Connector. David K getting a good tag onto Exodus, but from above, Minis is coming in with his AK. It's a plant bomb, why do you put... Well, it doesn't matter, Soon is trying to keep the CTs from getting in there, picks up a rifle, has reloaded first. The CT's on the retake already, but 3-man gets picked off by Minis, doing a good job with his triple kill already. Soon pushes through the back lines, gets another one, and Phaser is his last victim. Pride with a 14-7. Oronyx don't get the grip on the game. They got 2 rounds in a row. It looked like they are back in the game, but the terrorist Tech 9 buy broke them again. And I wonder why they put the bomb in the hands of Minis with the AK. I would put the bomb in the hands of the guy with the least important weapon. So when he plans, we still have all the rifles to cover him and all the strong guns pointing at the CTs. But hey, I think he probably picked it up on the way. Now 2 kills for the terrorists. The CTs hanging on to the economy. They know how close Pride is to winning this whole best of 3 and getting themselves to the semi-final. Oronyx definitely not out yet, thanks to 3-man's double kill, but he goes down to Morels. And now it's David K coming in from Popdog. He's already pre-aimed at fire control. And despite not making a sound, which we actually saw thanks to the glow, he's not gonna surprise anyone anymore. Pride with 8 match points, but Oronyx didn't disappoint yet. They still fight, and some spirit left. Reaper with a nice kill though. Oh, he's getting a second. Vopa, I missed it, I'm sorry. 16-7 in favor of Pride. And, well, that was a well-deserved win on Train. They never gave Oronyx anything to work with. And I thank you for tuning in. We will be back with another Best of 3 series later on. I will keep you updated in the chat and obviously also on the overlay. Lots of love to you out there. Love you guys. You've been awesome tonight so far. I hope you stay around for the second Best of 3 too. And I hope that you appreciate my job as well. If you do so, follow me on Twitter. It's at DaboTV, DABOOTV. And of course, you can also follow Go Champions League as well. I will give you all the info in the chat. Thanks. Stick around for some advertisements and make sure to check back for the second Best of 3.